Tyler here from Unleashed with a short demo for you of the software and what it can do for your business. This will be a very brief overview, and there's a lot of functionality here that I'll be skimming over. So if you do see something you want to know more about, just get in touch for a one-on-one demonstration, or you can start a two-week free trial of the software yourself. But with that said, let's begin by quickly looking at the dashboard. Now, it's surfacing some top level information in my Unleashed account. As you can see, I've got some alerts. These are some useful, important daily actions. I can see I have some older products here that I'll need to do something with. And the only thing I want to mention here on screen is my stock on hand value, this value you see. That's telling me the total value of my stock that I'm holding currently, and it's calculated by multiplying the amount of stock by the average landed cost for each different item. Now, I mention this because Unleashed works on a weighted average landed cost method of inventory accounting. So it's taking an average of all the different prices I've paid for goods over time, which is weighted according to how much I bought at each price. And the landed part of that is just about recognizing all those other costs beyond the actual purchase price. So things like freight charges, labor, duties, and so on. Unleash lets you track all those variable costs, which in turn gives you a very precise view of things like profit margins. Now, I won't go into it all right now, but I could, for example, quickly drill in to see some of those margins for every different product and see different margins by location, product group, by sales channel, but even by salesperson as well, which is a very useful part of the way Unleash tracks and records your costs. But let's go look at one of the main uses you'll find with Unleashed, which is purchasing. There's a lot of functionality in here that'll help you with your replenishment and ordering. And a really great place to start with that is the reorder report. A lot of Unleashed users will be in here weekly or even daily, so they stay on top of their buying and avoid some of those disruptive stockout situations. This is a very popular workflow. And as you can see, it generates a list of items that need to be purchased. And I can set different parameters on this page. So for example, I can run this by warehouse or by supplier. And the key thing here is it's a functional report. So it's a place where you can action your entire purchasing workflow. Now, to give you an example, I'm just going to select a few items here. And if I hover over this action cog wheel, I can actually create a purchase order on screen. Now, one step further from that is if you've assigned some default suppliers against your product record, it'll actually suggest that in the PO creation process. So you can see here, if I just click on create purchases, there are now purchase orders created against these products. Better yet is if they're different suppliers, you can actually create multiple POs at the same time. Now, if we just follow this workflow, you can see by clicking on the PO that I'm taken to the PO itself, and you can do a quick review of any of the items that might need to change. If it's all good, simply click place, and that instantly sends an email to your supplier, and the order is now underway. So super speedy, efficient, and tons of flexibility in that. Now, there are a lot of other ways I could have initiated that purchasing process as well. I could simply just go in and create the purchase order manually. I could purchase it from a single supplier if that was my preferred workflow. I could be responsive and initiate that purchasing process directly from a sales order, or even as I'm doing my production planning through assembly. And it's a really great functionality there that I'll show in a moment. For now, I just want to go back to those minimum and maximum levels in the reorder report. So just asking the question, where do these come from? In Unleashed, those are set at the product level. So I could easily go in there and tweak those levels as needs be, which will ensure that I'm getting those prompts in my reorder report to repurchase at the right time. And that maximum level will stop me from overbuying. But of course, for many people, there's a real challenge around knowing just how to set the right levels. And often that's happening off platform. And long planning meetings trying to work out rate of use and lead times, which as we know, can be quite dynamic. And of course, with the amount of capital tied up in this inventory, those are really business critical decisions. So if that sounds like you and your company, then I'll quickly show you a very, very useful tool in Unleashed. This is Advanced Inventory Manager, or AIM, the latest optional module for Unleashed. And one of the very powerful things it does is automatically detect lead times. So basically how long goods take to get to you, as well as rate of sale or use if they're parts being used up in manufacturing or assembly. And what AIM will do is generate a unique optimized minimum and maximum stock level for each product, then record it in Unleashed for you so that it surfaces in that reorder report we just looked at earlier. Let's look at that process now to see how powerful it is. So just here, I'm going to set some controls for one of my warehouses, and I want it to set it for 12 months, which actually is the default, so we'll leave that. So if I just put in some values and click calculate, I can see recommended levels right away. And you can see it's really fast. I could do that for hundreds or thousands of products at once. These figures are all editable, and I can just adjust that manually and just sense check everything. And once I'm happy, I'll just click here to update those numbers in the system. And now those new stock controls will come through in that reorder report I showed you. So by hitting submit, I can actually see a summary. And just by matching those levels to my actual needs, I can see I've released capital from my purchasing cycle. So it's really amazing functionality here, especially for those companies juggling a large number of product lines. So I do encourage you to check that out, especially as it also includes a full inventory and forecasting and modeling section. But let's get back to the basic functionality of Unleashed and move on to some core inventory features. What I want to show you here, which of course is a big part of running any business, is stock taking or stock counting. The main thing to note here is that Unleashed removes the need to stock count for visibility. And that's because it's perpetual. And when we say that, it just means that it records all your stock movements as they happen, both in and out. And it's very common for people to use barcode scanners. I mean, we integrate with all the main types as well. So as goods arrive in your warehouse, they're automatically added to the system, and likewise as they leave. Of course, you still do need to take stock takes for your annual reporting and to check for losses and so on. And Unleashed makes that process a lot easier. And I'll show you now. So looking at creating a new stock count, you can see here that I can even break down the details to look at it by section, which is a lot more realistic when you think about when people do count their stock and keep those businesses running. So we've got a lot of options and flexibility. You can break it down by warehouse. You can even search for a specific supplier, since you've got that default supplier record linked to the product, or even by bin location, which is a lot more practical when you think about when you're really counting stock. Now in here, when you're looking at the count itself, I can start to process the counting. I can add it into the system, or I can even pull that data out and do it offline and then add it later. But you can also do it by barcode. So if I just bring up this barcode icon here, it brings up a scanning option. So if you've linked the barcode number to the product, you just scan it in, and then you can save it and keep going. Even better too is the count can be done sort of in progress. So you may not get it all done tonight, just save the count and then work on that later. The other feature I'll show you now is batch tracking, but also called lot tracking, as well as serial number tracking. And these are very popular features with anyone needing to manage the age of their inventory. So for example, you know, food and beverage manufacturers, or anyone that's dealing in perishable stock. Serial number tracking is also useful for managing high value items, as well as after sales care. And there's a lot of ways you can add batch and serial numbers into the system. So traditionally, you're talking about purchase orders, but it may come in through stock adjustments. So you might have found some product that you need to account for in that manner too. So there's a lot of ways you can do it. But what I want to show you now is actually back on that dashboard we looked at the start. And you can see on my screen that I've actually got a bunch of expired goods and some that are due to expire soon as well. So from in here, I can actually run the batch number inquiry report. And if we look into that, you can actually get some more information on it, and I can export that data and start to do some proper digging into some products and see what's going on. Obviously, the most common situation that customers tend to sit on is things like product recall. It's very easy to do in our system. And the way we do that is through the batch number inquiry. You can export all that data and you can actually look at all the information and start to trace where things have gone, who you need to reach out to make sure that the customers are sorted and that the supplier is notified. So a lot of flexibility. Again, there's a lot of different workflows that's possible within the system. Unleashed is very flexible in that manner. So if you'd like to know more, just get in touch with us. In the meantime though, let's look at the production section. This will be very useful for manufacturers out there. So, you know, anyone that's working with contract manufacturers as well as anyone that's planning to buy products in bulk and break them down into sellable units, which is very common, or even for those who just want to sell kitted or bundled products in their system. Now, all of those processes are managed and unleashed through what we call assemblies. And assemblies in turn are powered by bill of materials, or BOMs, which are effectively recipes that dictate exactly what components are made of to create that product. Now, unleash stores and manages all that stuff and lets you create multi-level BOMs as well. So obviously sub-assemblies, giving you that ability to create complex assemblies when you need to. What I'll do for you though, is we're gonna just create a basic assembly in the system here and just see what it's made of. So by just generating an assembly, I can see here that I've got a can assemble quantity. Basically what that's telling me is I could theoretically make that much based on the components I've got to build it. And of course a common scenario, but maybe that you just don't have enough components to generate and complete that assembly. So part of the flexibility in Unleash is that you can actually purchase off the back of production. So I can raise purchase orders from this page to fulfill my raw ingredients requirements. So very useful in that regard as well. I can even set up custom statuses in the system to show off the progress of that assembly. So it may not be as simple as placing it and completing it. I might have a few steps in between that I want to consider. But when it's complete, I can actually go on and simply dispatch the goods all from within Unleashed and go on and start to create shipping labels and print shipping notes as well. So a lot there. So the last major area I want to show you today is the sales order management within Unleashed. So Unleash is a complete sales order management tool. So it gathers all those different sources of sales and lets you action them from a single place. So that might mean fulfilling from a warehouse of your own or from a 3PL, but it also might mean drop shipping directly from your supplier to your customer. Or it could even mean initiating production planning and execution that I've just touched on before. But let's look at that view sales order screen here. And you can see all these different sales orders from different channels. So I've got orders that coming in from my e-commerce website. I've got orders here from, or potentially could have from point of sale, but I've also got orders here from my B2B e-com platform. And just touching on that for a second, B2B is a native feature of Unleashed, and I can show you here a website that I've set up. It's a private portal that my on-account customers can log in and place orders with me directly. And that's something that saves a huge amount of time and error. It's entirely customizable as well, and I can, for example, set different pricing for different customers so they can see what I want them to see. And I can even build in different rates for different geographical areas so that I'm automatically factoring in that variable freight charge if needed. So let's just say, you know, we'll pick one of my orders from my view sales order page. We can actually just go ahead and fulfill it and get it shipped right away. So very quick. Now, there are situations where an order might come in and I don't have enough stock. In that instance, we need to obviously put things on back order and start purchasing from suppliers. So really quickly, if I just click on this here, go on my screen, and I can actually just create a purchase directly from my sales order. And the best part is that's linked. So now I can actually have traceability when it comes to that PO arriving. I can see it's related to this sales order in particular. And likewise, from a sales order, I can see the PO that it relates to. Now, with that allocated, my available stock on hand is adjusted, even though it may still be in my warehouse. So if you think about it now, we're just reserving that stock for a particular sale. And it also means that I'm not selling stock more than I have because it's being accounted for already. The beauty of actioning sales centrally, of course, is you have a single source of truth for your stock, and they're always up to date, no matter where those orders are coming from. And depending on how I choose to set up my integrations, I can ensure that my stock availability is flowing back into the sales channels as well. So a good example of that is Shopify and B2B. And then if I want to have that stock availability there, I can also choose to hide it or not. So you've got a lot of options in that system. We're almost done. And just while we're talking about integrations, I'll show you how those work in Unleashed. Obviously you've seen my e-commerce integration, which allows orders to flow back and forth as well as stock between the platforms. And I've also got a lot of options in here for tools such as CRMs, as well as a variety of fulfillment and analytic apps. Of course, accounting integrations are there as well, which I'll quickly show you now. Unleashed integrates with Xero and QuickBooks Online, as well as Access Financials, which is an accounting platform for much larger firms that need a high number of transactions. But as you can see on my demo account, I've got Xero set up. And the way it works is that it's more or less a one-way flow between systems. If you think of Unleashed as the stock master, it holds all the product detail, and Xero just simply needs to receive the value of the stock to make sure things balance. We do this by connecting to three different accounts: your sales account, your cost of goods, and your stock on hand. Now, I mentioned it is one way, but there are exceptions to this. We can pull customers and suppliers from Xero to your Unleashed account, which is great for that initial setup process. You're already, you know, partly the way there to going live. We also create streamlined automation. So the idea behind that is that when we create a purchase order and complete it, it instantly sends that to Xero. So you've got the bill in there to pay the supplier. And the best part is that for accountants especially is that we have reconciliation tools within Unleashed connecting to Xero, which makes sure that everything is balanced between both systems so there's no discrepancies as well. It's a super easy integration to set up. You just need your login details, assign some accounts and taxes, and boom, you're ready to go. Finally, Unleashed also works with a range of connector apps, and it has its own API access, which allows you to build tech stacks for your business that works for you. So there you have it. That's a very high level view. As I mentioned, there's a huge amount you can do with Unleashed. It's a very flexible yet robust tool. So if you'd like to learn more about using Unleashed in your business, just hit that button to book a chat, or you can start a free trial today.